Alright guys, how are we doing today? I had gotten these pins in the mail from a fellow tattoo artist. North Star Lady had featured a video that I had did. And so now somebody sent me these pins. And this is the packaging to those pins. High quality, multiple uses, comfortable, durable, with 60 unique vivid colors. So, sorry, hold on. So this is what came in there. And we're gonna get it on. I'm gonna do some coloring with these guys. See how she turns out here. Now mind you, I've never drawn with these pens or anything like that. So you guys will see exactly what I see for the very first time. And I'm just gonna put the pigment on the page as I would with any other pigment or application process. So get to it. Seems like the color comes out really nice and smooth. I don't have to touch the pen to the paper really hard or anything like that. And darkened right up real nice too. I'm gonna go back over it. It dries relatively quick. So that's cool. But of course, remember these are fine liners. Not really made to be covering all this area like I'm doing, but I just wanna really get a feel for them and get them flowing nice. It comes out really smooth. Definitely see the color variation that I did there. So that's cool. You can really see where the color on there. And so you can definitely change the pigment of the color really nice. So that's cool. I want to make it darker, lighter. Go right back over it. Change that pigment to dark. I also like how when I'm picking up my pen and then it's not leaving little dark spots. At least not that I can really see. There's one. But anyways, you get the gist of what I'm saying. It kind of blends into itself real nice. Excuse me. But yeah, if you guys enjoy what I'm doing and stuff, feel free to comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll keep I'll continue doing art with you guys. I love art, for sure. So, if you guys have ever tried the Reaeon pens, leave a comment down below and let me know what you guys think of them, if you've ever tried them or anything like that. This is definitely my first time, so, you know, I'm not sure how this picture is going to turn out. It's just going to be a mishmash of colors, because I'm just going to be trying out all of them just to see how they look. Yeah. shows up really good on the camera. Paper's just soaking it right up. That's the cool thing, so you don't have to worry about messing up your nibs. You just, you know, lightly touch the paper and the pigment goes right down onto the paper. It's nice and smooth. You can move right along. Got a little quick, got a little messy. But you can definitely move right along. Pigment. So I'm definitely enjoying that. And it's Inktober. So everybody celebrate your Inktober and get your Halloween pictures out. That's why I'm doing this little cat girl for Halloween. So we better do some Halloween colors, I guess, huh? Get the spirit of the holiday, I suppose. Yeah, I'm liking it. I'm liking them. I like the So I think I'm gonna take a break, but I'm gonna continue with the review. I just need to take a break, guys, for a minute. But yeah, so this is the Inktober Cat Girl with the Reaeon pens. Doing the review. I'm digging them so far. I will be back. Alright, so.
So when you pause yours, you can pause and it'll continue on?
I just unpaused it right now.
And it'll pause and then I gotta start over.
I think for the seeds, is this a different orange size? We're about to find out. Give it a whirly bird. No. Same effing orange. This one's got a brighter lid. Yeah, I forgot to show you guys the pens. These are the pens right here. This is what the tube looks like. They don't have, they're just color coded on the cap and the back. They don't have any numbers or anything like that, like the chameleons or anything, you know, they just got the color. But that's fine. All I really need to see anyways is the color. So oh yeah, that's a brighter orange right there. That's what we're going for. See that? I just barely got to touch the nib to the paper. That paper sucks it right on up. It's a Reba Berinsky. Halloweenish. A good pumpkin orange, you know. Yeah, I'm just, kind of trying to be careful with the nibs and stuff. That's why you see me just barely hitting the paper, because I'm trying to see, you know, how much force it really takes to get the pigment really flowing. And like I said before, it really, you don't have to really put any force down to get the ink flowing out of these, which is really nice. I like to just be able to kind of touch the paper and have the ink go flow right into the paper. So, I need to smooth this out. It's gonna be a little darker.